Hello friends, today we are discussing the numericals of the chapter solution. Some important numericals, how you will solve and what are the key points, important tips to solve numericals we will discuss. Calculate I value of potassium ferrocyanide. Which is 20% ionized. We will calculate I value of potassium ferrocyanide when 20% is ionized. That means here alpha value is 20%, means which is equal to 20/100. This is given, alpha value is given. I value is asked. Then we know the formula that alpha is equal to I minus 1 by M minus 1. M is the number of ions produced per molecule. Here I will be calculated minus 1 upon M. M here, potassium, 4 potassium ion and 1 ferrocyanide ion. That is, ferrocyanide is 4 minus, here potassium is plus. So, 4 plus 1, 5. So, 5 minus 1. That is how much? I minus 1 by 4. Which is equal to how much? 20 by 100. Then, if you solve it, try to solve it quickly. What is the value of I? Here implies, you will calculate now. I value will be 1.8. If you solve it, the value of I will be 1.8. That means, for this type of solution, when the ionization is 20%, I value is 1.8. That means I value also depends upon the alpha. If alpha will be more, then I will be also more. 20% dissociated, this much. 50% dissociated, this much. If 100%, suppose 100% dissociated, how much I value? 100% dissociated means I always equal to M. For 100% dissociated. So, for 100% dissociation, I value for potassium ferrocyanide will be 5. Because M value is 5. 4 potassium ion and 1 ferrocyanide ion. That's why 5 ions are produced. So, I value 5. For 100%. But question is 20%. That's why value is 1.8. So this is the first question. Second question is 1M glucose, 1M sodium chloride, 1M potassium sulfate. This much given. Question is, arrange in increasing order. Arrange in increasing order. First is del P. So 1M glucose, 1M NaCl, 1M potassium sulfate. Arrange in increasing order. What is first? del P. Del P you will calculate. Del P means relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering vapor pressure depends upon I value. Lowering of vapor pressure depends upon I value. If I value is more, then lowering of vapor pressure will be also more. Del P will be more. So, in which case here I value potassium sulfate for 100% dissociation, it is 5. For sodium chloride, I value will be 2. For glucose will be 1, because it is neither dissociated nor associated. That's why I value potassium sulfate is more, means first arranging increasing order. So lowest will be glucose, then sodium chloride, then potassium sulfate. Sorry, here potassium sulfate will be 3, because 2 potassium ion, 1 sulfate ion. So this is the relative lowering vapor pressure. Then del TB means elevation of boiling point. Elevation of boiling point depends upon same I value. Greater the I, greater the del TB. So same order. Do same order. Del P will be increased when I value increase. Del TB increase when I value increase. Del TF, del TF is same order, glucose less, potassium sulfate more, but del TF difference. Pi, osmotic pressure, same. What does mean? Means I value more means lower relative of vapor pressure. Vapor pressure will be more decreased. Del TB boiling point will be more increased. Del TF freezing point will be more decreased. Pi value will be more increased. All will be increased. Everything will increase when I value will be increased. But same question, what is the order of PA value? PA value means vapor pressure of the solution after adding the solute, non-volatile solute. What is the PA value? We know as its value is decreased, as the value is decreased, PA value will be more decreased. When I, as this value, del P is equal to PA naught minus PA. And del TB is equal to what? TB minus TB naught, and del TF is equal to del TF naught minus TF. So naught value is constant. As naught value is constant, del P increases means PA decreases. Del P increases means PA decreases. In case of TB, when TB increases means TB, del TB increases means TB increases because it's constant. Similarly, del TF increases means TF decreases. That's why vapor pressure more decrease if I value is more. That means it will be lowest. Less than sodium chloride, less than glucose. Second case, TB. What is TB? Boiling point of solution after adding solute. As boiling point increases, this thing remember, this all will be increased. All will increase by increasing what? I value. But this TB, if this will be increased, TB increases. So TB is which order? Increasing order. So glucose less than sodium chloride, less than potassium sulfate. Potassium sulfate has a high boiling point because I value is more. Then freezing point, freezing point as this value is more. This value is more when I is more, delta F is more. But delta F is TF naught minus TF. This TF naught is constant. So this value increasing means TF value is decreasing. That's my, the order is your potassium sulfate less than sodium chloride less than glucose. TF, that is TF list. Then pi value will be depends upon I value. If I value is more, then automatically the pi, that the osmotic pressure is high. So order is increasing order means glucose less than sodium chloride less than potassium sulfate. So this thing remember, greater I value the colligative property will be more, always more. Greater I value all four value will be more, but greater I value pressure will be decreased, boiling point will increase and freezing point will decrease, pi will increase. This is the order, remember. I is directly proportional to P TB. I is directly proportional to pi, but I is inversely proportional to TF. I is inversely proportional to PA. So this thing remember. Greater I value, boiling point is more. Greater I value, osmotic pressure is more. Greater I value, lower freezing point. Greater I value, lower vapor pressure. But all this colligative property will be always high. Del P will be high, del T B will be high, del T F will be high, pi will be high. So this is the very important comparison between all colligative property and individual vapor pressure, boiling point, freezing point and osmotic pressure. So this is regarding question number 2. In question number 3. Question number 3 is like this. It is a mixture of toluene and orthoxylene given. A mixture of toluene and orthoxylene given. And the PN0 of toluene, PT of toluene is given. And PO of, O means orthoxylene is given. For toluene is given how much? 400 torr. 400 torr. And for xylene, orthoxylene is 150 torr. It is given. This much given. Then question is another part given, total pressure is given. P total given 0.5 atm. 0.5 atm. 0.5 atm means in terms of torr, P total is equal to 0.5 into 760. Which is equal to how much torr? You calculate. The value will be 380 torr. This is given. Indirectly atm given, but you will calculate into torr. Okay. But question is, we will calculate what? Calculate the composition of both toluene and xylene in solution phase and vapor phase. We will calculate what are the mole fraction of toluene and xylene in solution phase and in her potash. This is the question. Very simple question, but you have to think about the mole fraction. Then you see, let mole fraction of toluene is T. Mole fraction of toluene is T. That is mole fraction of toluene. Mole fraction of toluene is how much? Mole fraction of toluene is ZT. Then we know the formula that PT is equal to PT0 and ZT. PT is equal to PT0 and ZT, which is equal to how much? PT0, as per the question is given, 400 into ZT. Then what is the value of P0? Implies P0 means partial pressure of orthoxylene is equal to PA0 into XI O, which is equal to PO0 into 1 minus ZT. In terms of ZT, we will calculate. Then here answer is, so PO will be, PO0 is, as per the question is, 150 into 1 minus ZT. This is the PO. But what is the total value as per the question? We know total, P total is equal to PT plus PO, means partial pressure of toluene plus partial pressure of orthoxylene. If you put this value, it will be how much? PT is how much? 400 ZT plus PO is how much? PO is, as per the question, which is equal to 150 into 1 minus ZT. So 150 into 1 minus ZT. This value is given as per the question. Total pressure is, as per the question, is 380, which is equal to 380. So if you solve, what is the value of implied, what is the value of ZT? Try to solve it taking this value. Pause the video and try to solve it. What is the result? Calculated? Okay. Here, ZT will be 0.92. 0.92. That is, mole fraction of toluene is 0.92 in solution phase. So, ZO will be how much? 0.8%. 0.8%. 0.8. So, mole fraction of toluene is this much and mole fraction of orthoxylene is this much. This is the calculation in solution phase. But in vapor phase, this is the solution phase. This is the solution phase calculation. In vapor phase calculation will be vapor phase, it will be, we know what, that ZT, let it is ZT gas, mole fraction of toluene in vapor phase
is equal to,
we know the, what is the mole fraction? What is the mole fraction of, that is pressure, that is PT naught. PT naught, and what is the value of JIT? PT naught into JIT upon what is the total pressure? What is the total pressure? Total pressure is 380, as per the question 380. PT naught. PT naught is, that is how much? What is the partial pressure? 400. It is given in the question. 400. Into JIT. What is the value of JIT? Already we have calculated. JIT is 0.92. Upon 380. So you have to calculate first JIT value. Then you will put in the JIT dash. What is JIT dash? Mole fraction in the vapor phase. That is your partial, that is your partial pressure in pure component. Partial pressure in pure component into JIT, its mole fraction, to the total pressure. That will be the partial pressure in the vapor phase. So 0.92, 380, you calculate, the result is how much? What is the value? The result is 0.968. That means this is the mole fraction of JIT. Then what is the mole fraction of, suppose, JI dash O? What is the meaning of JI dash O? That means ortho JI. It is 1 minus 0.968. It will be how much? 2, then 4, 2, then it is 9. How much result is coming? 9 1.00, then 0.968, that is 2, then here 4, okay, then how much? 0, 963, here it is 3, here this much, 0.032. 0.032. This is the mole fraction of ortho xylene, and this is the mole fraction of what? How much? Toluene. So in this way we can calculate the mole fraction. Then question number 4. Question number 4, that is, mixture of A and B given. Mixture of A and B given, and the total pressure is, the total pressure is given how much? 254 minus 119 into JA. This is given. It is a mixture of A and B, and total pressure, the equation is like this: 254 minus 119 JA. What is JA? Mole fraction of A. Question is, what is the value of what? Calculate PA naught and PB naught. You will calculate. How can you solve? You think first. It is based on the Raoult's law. We know that as JI is given, mole fraction of A is given, we know the formula that PT, total pressure in terms of JA, in terms of JA is equal to PB not plus what? Pa not minus Pb not into Ja A. This is the actual formula of Raoult's law. Pt, total pressure of A and B equal to Pb not plus Pa not minus Pb not Ja A. It is already derived. This formula you have to remember. So, this is the derivation. You compare this with the previous equation. What indicate? That means, as Ja A is multiplied with minus 119, Ja is multiplied with Pa minus Pb naught. That means this equation shows Pa naught minus Pb naught is equal to minus 119. As per the question. And Pb naught is equal to 254. This is given. The question is already given. 390 to 54 mm. So Pb naught is given. You put this value. So Pa naught minus 254 is equal to minus 119. Then Pa naught is equal to 254 minus 119. How much? 135 mm. So Pb naught is this much and Pa naught is this much. So very important in the calculation of that, this formula we have to use. Raoult's law formula, total pressure is equal to Pt, Pb naught, like this. In terms of Ja B, the formula is Pt is equal to Pb naught Pa naught plus Pb naught minus Pa naught into Ja B. This formula you will be used on this formula. But as the question is given in Ja A form, you have to use this formula. It is not given Ja B, that's why this formula will be used. So this is question number 4. Then 5. Question number 5. Question number 5 is like this. You will prepare a mixture of A and B. Solution A mix with solution B. The concentration of A is given 0.5 N, and concentration of B is given 0.1 N. Both concentration is given. Then after mixing, the volume is, total volume is 2 liter of concentration is 0.2 N. What is given? Volume of A, that is 1 acid solution, 1 HCl solution, volume is 0.51. This is also 1 HCl solution. This is also 1 HCl solution. Here 0.5 N. Here second HCl solution 0.1 N. And after mixing, the volume is 2 liter and concentration is 0.2 N. Question is, what is the question? Question is how much volume of V1 and how much volume of second solution added of taking this concentration to prepare 2 liter of 0.2 N. This is given. We know the dilution formula, or we know the dilution, that N1 into V1 N2 V2 upon how much is equal to N3 V3. This is called dilution formula. Dilution formula is initial strength, initial volume plus another added initial strength, initial volume, both solution. Then after mixing, how much strength, how much volume is always equal. This is the dilution formula. Then as the total volume is 2 liter, that means V1 plus V2 is 2. This is your equation. If you put this, then you put the value. N1 value is 0.5 and V1 is not known, plus N2 is 0.1 into V2 is not known is equal to how much? N3 is 0.2 and your V3 is 2. Okay, this is given. So this, and this equation you can written as, here you can write 0.5 V1 plus 0.1 V2 is equal to 0.4. 0.2 into 2, that is 0.4. This is equation 1, this is your equation 2, then we will solve it. How can we solve it? What will the value? 0.5 V1, 0.1 V2 multiplied here multiplied 0.5. Then what is the value? And minus. In equation 1 multiplied 0.5, and in equation 2 just remain, keep it like this. Then what is the value? If you multiply 0.5 here, then this value is cancelled. Okay, and how much left? 0.5 V2 and 0.,, after multiplying 0.5, it will be minus value. Equation, what is written? Equation 1 into 0.5 plus equation 2. This is our data. Equation 1 into 0.5 plus equation 2. So result is minus 0.5, that means result is minus 0.4 V2 is equal to how much? 2. 0.4 minus 2, that is minus how much? 1.6. If it is minus 0.6, what is the value of V2? You calculate. V2 is how much? 0.4. Okay. 2. Okay, 0.5 into 2 is 1. 0.5 into 2 is 1. Minus 1 plus 0.5. Result is 0.6. That is minus 0.6. Because 0.5 is multiplied with 2, that is 1. 1 minus 1 minus is minus, and 0.4, that is minus 0.6. So V2 is how much? So V2 will be, result is how much coming? 1.5. V2 will be how much? 1.5 liter. If V2 is 1.5 liter, then V1 plus V2 is 2, implies V1 is equal to 2 minus 1.5, that is 0.5 liter. So this is the V1 value and this is the V2 value. When this much of HCl added with this much of another HCl solution forming this much of volume and concentration, then question is, what is the unknown volume of first acid solution and second solution? You will calculate in this way. Very important for your competitive examination. Question number 6. 6 is like this. osmotic pressure of urea at 10 degrees Celsius at 10 degrees Celsius is how much? 500 millimeter given. U means urea here. So osmotic pressure of urea at 10 degrees Celsius is this much. And same at 25 degrees, osmotic pressure of urea at 25 degrees Celsius is equal to 105.3 mm given. Osmotic pressure for urea solution at two different solution is given. Question is, what is the extent of dilution? Extent of dilution. We will calculate the extent of dilution, means how much volume is increased. If osmotic pressure are 10 degrees this much and osmotic pressure at 25 degrees this much, then how much the extent of volume? Extent of volume means how much volume is increased. How will you solve? Let it will be solved like this. As pi of first solution, let it will be 1 and this is 2. First solution pi 1 is equal to, we know n by v1 into r into t. What is the value of t here? 10 degree means 283 Kelvin. This is 283 Kelvin. Then what is the value of second? Pi 2. Pi is equal to n. N is same. And v2 into r into 283. 28, 25 means 298. Okay? So if it is given, this value is 500 and this value as per question is 105.3. So you equation 1, equation 2. Then if you divide, then 500 upon how much? 105.3 equal to, here n will cancel, n by v1 by n by v2 is how much? V2 by v1, then this will be cancelled, which will remain here 283 upon 298. Implies what is the value of V2 by V1? V2 by V1 equal to how much? 500 upon 105.3 into 298 upon 283. You calculate what is the answer? Try to calculate it. The value will be V2 by V1, the value will be how much? Approximately how much coming? If you solve it, the approximately 5. That means V2 solution is 5 times of V1 solution. When the osmotic pressure of the first solution at 10 degrees this much and the second solution at 25 degrees this much, then how much volume is increased? How much volume is changed? The V2 equal to 5 V1. So in this way, you can, that is called extent of dilution. How much volume is increased or how much volume is decreased. That is the question number 6. Question is, here 1M solution for 1M solution, what is the mole fraction? This much simple question. If the solution concentration is 1 m means molality, then what is the what is the mole fraction? This can be calculated using one formula. What is the formula? That small m is equal to 1000 Ji B upon 1 minus Ji V into ma. That is one formula. Already we have discussed in the previous lesson that total formula, number different formula, that pi m is equal to molality is equal to 1000 Ji B 1 minus Ji B ma. If you put this value, m value is how much? 1 equal to 1000 into Ji B upon 1 minus Ji B into ma, means it is a dilution, aqueous solution, means 18 molar mass, that is 18. So if you solve, then implies Ji B equal to how much? You calculate, what is the value? Ji B, it will be how much? 0.0176. This is one method. In this way you can calculate. Another shortest method, another method you can do it for this type of solution, that as mole fraction is asked, what is the mole fraction? 1 n means how many moles? N B by N A plus N B, this formula we can use. As it is 1 n means 1 mole already present, number of mole is already 1 because 1 n solution. NA is 1 liter, 1 kg. 1 kg means number of mole is 55.5 for water. Then is 1. That is how much? 1 upon 56.5, which is equal to same 0.0176. In this way also you can calculate number of mole by total mole. That is also correct. Then question number 8. What is the question number 8? Calculate volume strength. Calculate volume strength of which type of solution? Volume strength of 1.5 N hydrogen peroxide. Means volume strength will calculate. We know hydrogen peroxide bottle is mentioned as X volume. X volume. It is mentioned as X volume. Like this. So volume strength means we will calculate how much volume of sulfuric, how much volume of oxygen produced by this much of H2O2. That is a calculation you will do like this. We know that hydrogen peroxide, if you balance it, it produces water and oxygen. This is the formula. So 2 into H2O2, that is how much gram? 32, 34 means 68. 2 means 68 gram. 68 gram produce oxygen at NTP 22.4 liter at STP. 2 mole H2O2, that is 68 gram, produce 22.4 liter at STP. 68 gram is this much, but here 1.5 N H2O2 is equal to how much gram? 1.5 N H2O2 equal to how much gram? 1.5 into how much? The equivalent mass of H2O2 is 17. Okay, equivalent mass of H2O2 is equal to how much? 17. So this much of gram of how much H2O2 in how much? 1.5 N. So after the equation, 68 gram hydrogen peroxide, volume of oxygen is how much? 22.4 liter. 1 gram is how much? 22.4 upon 68. But as for the question, 1.5N is how much gram? Into 1.5 into 17. What is 17? 17 is the equivalent mass of hydrogen peroxide. Because it is contain 2 hydrogen, 34 by 2, that is 17. So this much will be how much liter? You calculate it. How much liter? It will be how much liter? Calculate it. Answer is 8.4 liter. 8.4 liter at H2. That means, what is the volume? What is the volume of sulfuric hydrogen peroxide? The bottle? 8.4. That is, hydrogen peroxide bottle will be written as 8.4 liter. That means, 1 liter of hydrogen peroxide, 1 liter of hydrogen peroxide contain 8.4 liter of oxygen at NTP, at STP. This is regarding your question number 8. Question number 9 is, calculate osmotic pressure of the mixture containing how much? 100 ml of 3.4% urea with 100 ml of how much? 1.6%. 1.6% of sugar. This much of volume, this much of strength, this much of volume, this much of strength means percentage is given. Is my mixing, what will be the question is, what will be the osmotic pressure? Very simple. We know pi is equal to N by V RT. What is this? Pi is equal to N by RT. But question is here at 20 degree Celsius. 20 degree Celsius. Temperature is given. Pi will N by V RT. This is pi 1. What is the pi 1 value? N is how much? 3.4. You put how much? 3.4 by urea molar mass is 60. Then volume 100 ml, volume will be liter how much? 200 into 1000. Because 200 ml is how much liter? 200 by 1000. Then it will be numerator. Then R 0.0821. And T is 20 degree means 293. This much. If you calculate, this is the pi value. If you solve it, what is the answer? If you try to solve it, answer will be 6.82. 6.82 atm. Okay? 6.82 atm. That is for urea. And for sugar, N by V R T. Here, N is how much? 1.6 means 1.6 by urea molar mass is 342 into volume is 100. Here volume is 100. And here volume is how much? How much volume? Here one thing, as 100 ml and 100 ml result will be 200 ml. So volume will be 200 because mixture. We are calculating the concentration in the mixture means 100 plus 100 by 200. 100 plus 100 is 200. Here is for sugar also 100 plus 100 is 200. Into 1000. Into R 0.0821. Into 293. Same. So result is how much osmotic pressure? You calculate this much. value is how much coming? 0.568. So this is the pressure of the urea in the mixture. This is the pressure of sugar in the mixture. Mixture means how much? 100 ml plus 100 ml means 200 ml will be divided for the calculation of strength. Pi is equal to CRT. Pi is equal to CRT. Here direct concentration is not given. Percent is given. That's why N by V formula is used. So now what is the total osmotic pressure? R is a mixture. So pi is equal to total is equal to pi 1 plus pi 2. That is 6.82 plus 0.56. How much? That is 7.38. That is 7.38 atm. This is the pressure of the what? Mixture of this much volume urea and this much of sugar at temperature 20 degrees Celsius. Okay? Then last question, that partial pressure of cyclohexane given. Cyclohexane is given. How much? 280 mm. As per the question, it is given. And partial pressure of ethanol given. How much? 168 mm. This is the question as per the question data. Then mole fraction of cyclohexane is 0.32. It is given. It is given. Then what will be the mole fraction of ethanol? Is 1 minus 0.32. It is not given, but you can calculate like this. How much? 8. Then 0.68. This is the mole fraction of what? Ethanol. Means ethanol contain more amount and cyclohexane contain less amount in terms of mole. Then total pressure is given. As per the question, total value is given. When you mix this, the total pressure of the mixture is 376 mm. Question is given. Total pressure given, mole fraction of cyclohexane given, partial pressure of pure component cyclohexane given, partial pressure of ethanol given, but we have to calculate partial mole fraction of ethanol is 1 minus this much. Again, question is, we'll prove it whether the question is whether it is an ideal or non-ideal solution. We'll prove it. Whether this mixture is an ideal or non-ideal solution, we'll prove it. How can you prove? Very easy. First, calculate total pressure. How much coming? But as per the question, total pressure is given. But practically you calculate how much is coming. When this mixture, this component will be mixed, how much total pressure is calculated value, just you calculate. So we know the formula. What the formula? Total pressure is equal to partial pressure of cyclohexane plus partial pressure of ethanol. C means cyclohexane, E means ethanol. Short form I have written like this. Okay. Then PC is equal to P naught as per the Raoult's law of cyclohexane into JC plus P ethanol is P naught of ethanol into mole fraction of ethanol. If you put this, how much coming? P naught is how much given? 280 into what is JC as per the question? 0.32 plus what is P naught ethanol as per the question? 168. What is already ethanol mole fraction already calculated? 1 minus this much, that is 0.68.
Okay? So how much is coming?
You see the multiply and add. Just pause the video and calculate how much is coming. I am giving 1 minute. Maximum 1 minute. How much coming? Okay, let me do. Answer is 203.84. How much mm? This is your P total. But actually it is how much coming? As per the question, the total pressure is 376. But here pressure is 203. Pressure is increase or decrease? As pressure is decrease or pressure is increase, means it is not an ideal solution. As decrease means it is negative deficient. Pressure is decrease means it is a negative deficient. It is clearly question is whether it is an ideal solution or not. As it is not matching with the actual value, if it is approximately this value, then you can say it is ideal solution. Because very large difference, because decrease means it is a negative deviation, means non-ideal solution of negative deviation. Negative deviation. Why negative deviation? Because ethanol and cyclohexane, what will be? Pressure is decreased, means interaction occurs. That's why the pressure, total pressure decreases. Pressure decreases because we know negative deviation del P mixing less than zero. When pressure, total pressure will be less than actual value, that is negative deviation. If del P greater than zero, greater than actual value, then it will be positive deviation. That's why it is a non-ideal solution, not ideal solution, but what type of deviation? Negative deviation. So these are the very interesting questions. So many questions you can solve like this. But one thing you remember, try to save your time. You have to use direct formula and put the data and calculate quickly so that you can solve the problem in time. Okay, thank you.